Hello everyone, great that you're with us again in the course. In this video, we are dealing with uncertainty in the complex problem situation you analyze. Can you remember from the video on causal diagramming that there are always factors in your system that no one can influence? Here they are, in green. We call them external factors, meaning they are factors in your system, but they have an influence on your system without you having the possibility to change them. They are autonomous, so to say, and come from the outside, external. They may be external, but as you can see in the diagram, they do influence other factors in your complex problem situation. That means that they also influence the criteria via the causal relationships. And these criteria represent everything that you and your actors find so important. So there are factors in your complex problem situation that you cannot influence, but they themselves do change the value of your criteria. Here is how a scenario analysis can help in dealing with these external factors. Imagine you are a car dealer and you want to build and open a new shop for your company somewhere in a densely populated and industrial area. With the help of the techniques that you've learned so far, you developed a problem diagram. In it are quite a few interesting alternatives for building this new store. But the future is uncertain. You can see this, as in your problem diagram, you have indicated some external factors. They act autonomously and do influence your criteria. This means that you are not able to predict how the system will evolve in the future. Thus, you do not know how well your alternatives will be able to deal with possible futures. As a car dealer, you have most benefit of a solution that functions well in many possible futures. Business is going well, and I would like to expand my company property. But can I open a new shop in Amsterdam? And if I can open a new shop in Amsterdam, where would be the best location? I better call a consultant to help me decide.
I can help you out. To help the car dealer, I will first make a problem diagram. To deal with uncertainty, I take a closer look at the external factors. These are the factors in the problem diagram which the problem owner is unable to influence. In case of the car dealer, important external factors are, for example, the oil price and the land prices of empty building plots. Let's say that these are the only external factors that influence the attractiveness of a certain location for opening a new shop. Now I can explore these factors based on their uncertainty and impact. In this table, I will place the two external factors based on their level of uncertainty and impact. The land price is a factor with quite a high level of uncertainty and also a high impact, because the price the car dealer pays for the building ground covers a large part for the total investment cost for a new shop. History has shown these prices vary a lot. The oil price also has an even higher level of uncertainty, as history has shown us. Again, the impact is also high because the oil price influences the attractiveness of car driving and the demand for new cars. As both these factors are uncertain and have a high impact, they provide very interesting material for a scenario analysis. Based on these two factors, for example, I will consider four scenarios. Scenario 1 has a high oil price and the prices for land are also high as well. In scenario 2, the oil prices are high as well, but buying land to build on is more profitable than in scenario 1. In the third possible scenario, the oil price is low and driving a car is therefore very attractive. However, the land prices are high. A final scenario that I will use to test the alternatives is a scenario in which both oil price and the land prices are low. Thinking about these scenarios provides me with more insight about how the future could possibly develop, and it helps to draw some conclusions. What I will do for the car dealer is to create a scorecard for each scenario. We already talked about scorecards in the estimate video. They are nothing more than a table that shows the effects of all alternatives on all criteria. With that table, the car dealer can see what the effect of his alternatives are for each possible and plausible future. Implementing an alternative in one scenario will have a different effect on the criteria than implementing that same alternative in another scenario. In the eyes of the car dealer, scenario 4 is a future he would like to see happening. In this scenario, car driving is highly attractive and constructing a new shop is relatively cheap. On the other hand, he hopes that scenario one will not become real, but he has no influence on how the world will look like in the future. So, what he is looking for is an alternative that is not just performing well in one of the scenarios, but is able to deal with as many different scenarios as possible. He's looking for robust solutions that can stand the test of time.
I'm Bert Ensering, and I'm the Director of Studies of the Engineering and Policy Analysis Master Program. And I'm a researcher here at Delft University of Technology. And I'm a specialist in policy analysis and in dealing with uncertainty, decision making under uncertainty. And one of the methods we use a lot is scenario analysis, future studies, we call it. And for instance, we often get requests by companies about what will be a good strategic pathway for our future investments. We had a client, for instance, a big company, Caterpillar, who is having industries in Poland and Romania and in the Netherlands, and they had to decide where to put their production in the future, and big investments to be made, and a lot of uncertainty. What will happen with the EU? What will happen with the euro? What the exchange rates? What's the political future in the eastern part of Europe? A lot of uncertainty, and what we did was make a couple of scenarios, combine different trends, and see how this company would have to behave in these different futures. And that allowed them to make a very conscious decision about their strategy. Well, these kind of problems are relatively simple. They get more complex if a lot of parties are involved. And scenario studies can be very helpful in these kind of situations where there are a lot of uncertainties, external events happening that people don't have any influence on, and where you have to decide on strategic important issues for your company, for your government, for anything, for policy making. In this course, we learn the basic methods for scenario analysis. In practice, of course, the futures are and models are much more complex. Think, for instance, about the climate change models. And these are typical models that are used in a scenario environment with different futures, with extensive modeling. And that's, of course, not what we're going to do in this course, but the basics are very important, and that's what we teach you over here.
This video has introduced you to the basics of scenario analysis. Now let's try and apply this to your own complex problem situation. Chapter 4 in the book describes the essence of scenario analysis. Please, before you start making scenarios for your own case, study this chapter. After that, identify the external factors in your causal diagram. How do you categorize them using the axes certain, uncertain, and high impact, low impact? Your categorization determines which of these factors are a candidate for scenario analysis. Take the ones with high impact and high uncertainty. The others are less interesting. If their impact is low, it makes no sense to consider them further in your analysis. If they're very certain, there's no need to make scenarios, as you already know what this factor will look like in the future. Now you have your scenario factors. What useful scenarios can you create for your analysis? In this video, we showed a quantitative description of such a scenario, but we also try to make a little story of it. In the end, the numbers don't say all that much. Much more important is what the scenario looks like. Scenarios are possible future states of the situation you're analyzing. You can describe those states in words. Usually, this description makes it much more clear for other people. People don't just want to know that the oil prices are high. They're interested in what the world looks like when they are. When you have your scenarios, you link them to your analysis by making a scorecard for each of them. If you have 4 scenarios, you make 4 scorecards. If you have 30 scenarios, you make 30 scorecards. In the end, you have to compare all these scorecards. If you do that manually, you better not have too many. However, if you use a computer, you might be able to do an analysis of millions of scorecards. We have seen many mistakes in scenario analysis over the years. I also made them in the past, no worries. It will happen to you too. That's just how you learn. Here are the two most common mistakes when making a scenario analysis. The first one is that when identifying external factors, people often say that the client cannot influence it. This is indeed true, as it is the definition of an external factor. However, it is not an explanation why this is an external factor. For that, we need to know why the client cannot influence this particular factor. People around you need an argument why that factor needs scenario analysis. Making more scenarios is more work and more expensive. Clients therefore tend to force you to reduce the number of scenarios. They will challenge the explanations of your external factors, so you'd better have good ones. Another common mistake is that some consultants or managers make a prediction of the future and then use that prediction as a scenario. For example, I expect the oil prices to be 120 euros per barrel in 2025. This is not dealing with uncertainty in your analysis. This is saying that there is no uncertainty at all. Apparently, your manager seems to know what the future will look like. Okay, go ahead with your problem situation now. Apply the scenario technique and see what it brings you.